As of April 23, 2023, there are currently 43 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is a famous Nyiragongo stratovolcano in the Democratic Republic of Congo, which contains a fairly rare feature within its 1,250-meter-wide summit crater. Within this is the largest of the 8 active lava lakes currently on the planet, which frequently bubbles and spatters material into the air. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Costa Rica, the Rincon de la Vieja volcano produced a fairly large explosive eruption, at least in the context of the last decade of activity at this crater lake-filled volcano. Meanwhile, on the French island of Reunion, which has a population of around 850,000, a volcano produced a seismic crisis, suggesting that it is likely to erupt at some point in the next 2 weeks. And for this week's top story, the Taal volcano in the Philippines, after going 6 months without an eruption, is now displaying its best chance of producing a new phreatomagmatic eruption. People who live around Taal Lake might have noticed that since April 16, significant vog or volcanic haze has developed. This is because between April 6th and April 20th, sulfur dioxide emissions have increased by 143%, likely indicating that an increased amount of shallow magma is present. Alongside this increase, a sustained plume of up to 3,000 meters or 9,842 feet in height of volcanic gases from Taal's crater lake occurred on April 21st, whereas beforehand Taal's gas plume height merely averaged around 900 meters. Then, on April 21st, 4 volcanic tremors occurred. On its own, this isn't that much, but altogether they lasted for 32 minutes. Clearly, either gas emissions, magma, or a combination of both were moving through the subsurface. I am leaning towards this being magma, as for several months now, Taal had been as a whole deflating, largely due to patches of its magma chamber partially solidifying and thus contracting. However, on April 20th, the northwestern sector of the Taal volcano began to inflate, meaning the ground was pushed slightly upwards. Taking all this into account, it appears that another small group of phreatomagmatic explosions of a small to medium size is quite possible the next 2 weeks. However, for an unknown reason, this volcano is absurdly difficult to predict, as on some prior occasions it has erupted when geothermal data was pointing towards it not erupting, and has not erupted when geothermal data suggested an eruption was highly likely. In other words, it is quite possible that no eruptions will come of this activity. On the French island of Reunion, a seismic crisis began at the Piton de la Fournaise shield volcano on April 21, 2023 at 3:11 p.m. local time. This was, in my opinion, most likely caused by a rapid intrusion of magma moving towards the surface, generating earthquakes along the way. However, this did not occur alongside ground deformation, and 69 minutes later, the seismic crisis ended. At this volcano, although seismic crises can occur in isolation, they often occur in the days or weeks preceding an eruption. Thus, a new eruption of Piton de la Fournaise is possible by May 4th, 2023, that, in my opinion, if it were to occur, would begin in the zone I have outlined on screen. In Costa Rica, there are 3 volcanoes currently at a raised alert level. These are Turrialba, Poás, and the topic of this segment, Rincon de la Vieja. The latter 2 of these 3 have active crater lakes, which are the site of fairly frequent phreatic eruptions. In these eruptions, small amounts of intruding magma interact with the overlying lake water, causing it to flash to steam within the magma conduit, build in pressure before exploding upwards. The Rincon de la Vieja volcano began one such new phreatic eruption on April 22nd via an explosion which occurred at 3:50 p.m. local time, sending a plume of ash and steam via primarily white plume to a height of around 3,800 meters. Due to some of the eruptive products boiling over, it generated pyroclastic flows which reached up to 2 kilometers away from its active crater. As a result, in my opinion, it is best to keep at least 5 kilometers away from its active crater in addition to staying away from drainages at slightly further distances where a lahar might travel. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on April 22nd of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Peter Jaros for becoming a new patron on this channel's Patreon page.